Clearwater Hats, we've been in business about 20 years now. And we use some of the best materials that you can make a hat from, which is beaver and rabbit fur. It's actually European rabbits mixed with the beaver. We also use period equipment.
Well, our equipment is pretty old. One of the things about hatting is that it's, especially for small hatters like we're a small company, and so to have some of the pieces of equipment that we have is very unique. We have brim trimmers. We do use modern steamers, but the blocks that we have are pretty old. We don't use modern blocks. We still use the old styles, the old sizes, and it helps make our hats unique. The blocking machine is from the 1870s, and it is one of only about 20 in the country. A lot of hatters have a blocking machine. Not many, but a few have a blocking machine. And it helps begin the process. Once we get the body, it's the first step in blocking the hat.
Yes, all of our hats are made by hand, using the same type of machinery that they used back in the 1800s. And we really pride ourselves on making a hat that is exactly made the same way, made the same handmade way that they were made back in the old days. And so they're historically accurate, and we go to great lengths to make certain that they are accurate. We use period makers' names, we hand sew the insides, and we studied the hats, and so we use the same materials and the same techniques that they used back prior to the year 1900 in order to make the hats.
We're a very specialized company for many things because we make hats from history, and we've done so much research that our hats seem to really fit people's needs for whatever time period they want to use to be.
Most of our hats are from the French and Indian War time period, 1750 through the Red War time period, the fur trade, War of 1812, up through the Civil War and then the Old West. So we cover probably about 150 years of history with our hats. And we've studied the type of hats that were made, when they were introduced, and who introduced them, at what point in time and where in the country, and also different levels of society would wear different hats at the same time.
Well, for gentlemen, no one went without a hat. If you were outside, you needed protection for your head, of course, you know, physical protection, but a hat also signified your position in society. It signified, you know, a top hat, for instance, was a hat of a gentleman. A gentleman would wear a hat like that to signify that he was a personage of importance. A working person's hat would be something that someone would wear just, you know, for protection. But when you got to old Western times, you began to see people in hats that began to state more of a personality rather than so much a status. We provide a service that not many people do, and the service that we provide allows people to make whatever character they want to be, whatever time period they want, whatever personality their character would have. When I look at the hats, I see all the different styles and time periods that are here, and we're able to completely outfit. Someone might say, well, what do I need to be a circuit riding preacher in East Tennessee in 1792? Well, I'd be able to help them see how their costume can be enhanced by the hat and guide them to the right crown style, the right body shape.
Yes, we have. We've made hats for a number of movies. We've made hats for Mel Gibson and the Patriots, and for the Alamo, and for 310 to Yuma. And our latest was for Cowboys and Aliens, and that was a lot of fun. Made a lot of hats for TV and the History Channel, and also for Broadway plays and for operas, for museums all over the world. And we've even consulted with a number of museums, and one of our hats was shown in the Smithsonian. We do a few custom hats, but we're not real fast in getting our hats done. It takes normally about 10 to 12 weeks get hats done, and that's if you order a hat that we have all the materials in place. If it's something we have to order, it may take much longer than that, up to 4 to 6 weeks, 6 months. I just want to say one more thing that my daughter is forcing me to do this, and I have no say in it. And after this, she's going to untie me and let me out of the room.